Hello developers, my name is Brian and I'll be your Clover DevRelian for today's topic. We'll be covering the types of fees that could be added to a Clover order. How exciting! Here is today's agenda. We'll be covering service charges, taxes, and lastly, we'll wrap up things with some resources and support information. Our first category is service charges. Service charge is a fee collected to pay for services related to the primary product or service being purchased. Clover has the ability to have custom service charges, so you're probably wondering what are the different types of custom service charges that can be applied to a Clover order? Let's find out. Here is a list of example service charges you may see on a Clover order. Please note, there can be other service charges based off a business vertical, like booking fee, maintenance fee, and security fee. I will be providing some summaries of these different custom service charges. Service fee is a fee charged by certain government and higher education clients following registration with the card brands. Gratuity is a charge that is added to the bill of the customer at a restaurant. Typically, this gratuity is 18 to 20% of the bill, although an establishment may choose a higher or lower automatic gratuity. You'll probably see this a lot on a bill when you have a party of six at a restaurant. Convenience fee is a fee charged by the merchant to the cardholder for the bona fide convenience of using alternative payment outside of their customary payment channels. Convenience fee is very popular when buying tickets online. Delivery fee is a fee charged for food delivery to a customer. Oftentimes, this can be a third-party food delivery service hired by the merchant. These are screenshots on where you might see the service charge from a REST API call. The REST API is expanding the payment to show the service charge. The JSON response will display the expanded service charge with its UUID, name, and the amount it was charged, and also another reference to the payment ID. Here is a snippet of a GET REQUEST API call to gather information on what service charge are on the merchant's account. The JSON response will provide the important stuff, like its ID, name, and the amounts. There is also a POST REQUEST API call to add a service charge on the merchant's account. Please make sure you have the necessary read and write permissions to access these GET and POST calls on the merchant's account. Smells like pop quiz time. How many service charges can be added on a Clover order? The correct answer is one. Keep this in your back pocket. Our second category is taxes. We're going to be talking a little bit more about sales tax. Sales tax is a tax paid to a governing body for the sales of certain goods and services. Laws allow the seller to collect funds for the tax from the consumer at the point of purchase. Depending on business vertical, you may see additional taxes like drink and food tax. Here are screenshots of the taxes on the Clover order from a REST API. The REST API is calling the payment and expanding the tax rates. The JSON response will display the tax rates on the payment. Please note, if the merchant has multiple tax rates, they will each display on the JSON response with their name, percentage, and what amount was charged. Here is a GET REQUEST API call to gather all the tax rates on the merchant's account. The JSON response returns things like the tax name, the rate or the amount, and what inventory items are tied to it. An item can have multiple tax rates. On the other hand, a POST REQUEST API call will add a new tax rate to the merchant's account. You can also assign what items will have this tax rate. I smell another pop quiz. How many tax rates can be added to a Clover order? The correct answer is many. Remember, items can have multiple tax rates. Please follow your region's rules and regulations when utilizing taxes and service charges. That completes our tutorial for today. Please take a look at our resources. We do have our Clover Docs, API references, and 24/7 community to answer any questions you may have. We look forward to seeing what you build.